Hello guys and welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to install Pycharm. I'm going to walk you through the steps of installing Pycharm, which is actually my favorite IDE for Python programming, and it's actually the best in my opinion. So the first thing you need to do is you need to there are two options of installing. One, you can either go to their website jetbrains.com/pycharm/download, and then of course /Linux. So there are two options still, that is professional edition and the community edition. So this is for pure Python development. Professional one is for scientific web, that is HTML, JS and SQL, but the community one is just for Python, and it's free and it's open source. So we are going to install the community edition. Now there are two ways. You can either install using the terminal, that is the snap packaged one, which you can just go to the terminal, just copy this, that is sudo snap install Pycharm community --classic, and then head over to your terminal by pressing Ctrl Alt and T, or just searching for terminal and installing, and then copy this one, copy this command, or just type and then paste it here, and then press enter. Once you press enter, you will be prompted to enter your admin password, which you will enter, and the installation process will begin and finish as long as you have good internet. So that is the first option, the easiest one, but it consumes more storage, and so I prefer the second installation method, which entails in downloading the compressed file. From here, just click download. I've already downloaded mine, and it is here, Pycharm Community 2021 tar file. So I just need to extract it. So once it is extracted, you'll need to decide where to install it, or where the installation files will sit. For me, I prefer them to be in the home folder, that is the application files for Pycharm. So I'll just move this to the home folder, and then in the home folder there is no need to retain it as 2021.22, because this is the version that we are installing at the moment, but it will always update to the latest version. So you just need to rename it like I always do. I normally rename it to Pycharm, so because that is the one that you'll be using from now on. And then go open the folder, and then open the bin folder inside it, and then click away or right click outside any file. Don't click a file, just click outside, click away, and then once you click away, just open in terminal and then run the following, enter the following command to run the executable file Pycharm sh. Do not import. So I'll create a project and then call it, yeah, just leave it as Python project. And then since we are installing in Ubuntu or Linux, you will not need to install the SDK for Python. So you just need to create. If it was on Windows, you will need to install the Python SDK. So from there you need to go to the tools option and then create desktop entry so that you will not need to use the command line or the terminal to start the application. So click OK and then enter your password. So that way you will have created the desktop entry for Pycharm, and if you come here to your applications and search Pycharm, you will see that it is there and you can add it to your favorites so that you can fire it up easily anytime. So that is the way to install Pycharm, the second method, which consumes less storage and which I normally use as my preferred method of installation. Thanks guys for watching, and look out for more videos. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot.